Hello and welcome, my beautiful Libras. Brenda here with your general tarot and oracle card forecast for the week of March the 6th to the 12th, 2023. Let's get started right off the bat. The card on the bottom of the deck and your all over energy, my beautiful Libras, is that of the Seven of Pentacles. I think you're going to be making plans. You're pretty organized and logical anyway, Libras. That tends to be what you do. You're investing your time into something here, and you're waiting to see when this is going to come come into focus here. Things will be coming into fruition, and your hard work will be paying off. So some of you might be making more money. You might be seeing an increase in profit. Your business might be improving, or you might be stepping up the ladder into a higher seat of power at work. I do think that you're going to see some payouts coming in here for the efforts that you've made. Some of you could have possibly put out a proposal, an idea, and also a resume, and you're waiting to hear how it's been received and how they've reacted to it and when you're going to hear from them. Patience, okay? This is all about patience, because you are growing, and you're going through this sort of nurturing and gestation period of patience while you're in that process of planning. This will happen, okay? Whatever this is you've been working on and working towards, it will happen. It's just taking time. Okay, but keep investing your time into it, because it's definitely going to help. Okay, so coming in your first row, possibly the beginning of the week or past tense, or the energy coming in behind you, I love it. You've got the Ten of Cups. So this is all about, we call this the Happy Ever After card, and this is all about progress moving forward, and it has to do also with families and being happy within your family circle here. This can be marriages, long-term relationships, stability, security, reunions, anything like that where you're getting together in community or family situations. I do think that now you're at a point where relationships are going to be comfortable and secure. I think that you're going to be having a much better relationship with your children if you've been having any issues. And also, there is this strong unit, like a marriage, a strong unit being created here with those that you choose to be with in your life. I think this is going to be great. And also, you're now able to see a clear sight line towards your goals and your happiness and your success. And you truly can now believe that there is that pot of gold, that jackpot at the end of the rainbow. Coming in with that, you've got clean up. So there could be some unfinished work here that you need to get done. Ever feel bogged down, like with emotional junk and gunk, and you can't think straight? Well, could you be surrounded by physical clutter around you? You might be tidying up. You might be cleaning up your home or your office or your sacred space. Are you doing too much work? Are you being overwhelmed? Now is the time to make out priority lists, to make things and adjust things that are going to make your movement forward much more comfortable and going at your pace. It's about cleaning up and tying up loose ends. If there's any unresolved issues or work that you've kind of put on the shelf, now's the time to complete that. Get out there and get that done. You have this ability now to go after what you want. And simple things like, just getting things tidied up around you. This is clearing out things that aren't serving you as well, so that you have this clear sight line to know what you're going after. Getting rid of things that don't help serve you, that may be bogging you down. How are you thinking? Your emotions as well. Cleaning out those thought patterns as well, so that you can be open to positive. Okay, coming in next, the Burden card, of course, the Ten of Wands. Pushing yourself so hard, thinking you're Superman or Wonder Woman, and 9 out of 10 times you do complete the task at hand. However, now you've depleted your energy level. So it's time now not to overload yourself or to stress yourself out with problems. It's time now to let go of weighing that weight on your shoulders of taking on everybody's burdens. You tend to have this ability, some of you Libras, to step up to the plate, and you get down to business and you do get things done. But there comes a time where even you now have to realize that you have to take care of your needs and nurture you. So you worked hard for something and you reached that pinnacle there. Now you're coming down the other side of the mountain and you're realizing, I'm not going to do this again. I'm not going to take on these extra jobs. I'm not going to take on other people's burdens. I'm going to clean house. I'm going to clear up. I'm going to get rid of those burdens. And now your path is clear. You're getting over that drudgery. You're getting over feeling that burnout and having to struggle and push weight uphill. There's a new start coming in here. This is the new moon coming in with a moonology deck, and it's a beautiful new beginning for you. So this is all about you moving forward, all about you realizing that there's new things coming into you and being aware of them and being open to them. You know, you're changing your ways here. Definitely you're cleaning things up and you're realizing that you're not going to take on all this work anymore. And in essence, this is a new beginning for you, starting to do things that matter for you. So whether you're starting a new job, a new relationship, you're moving to a new location, there is something new coming in, a new start for you. Coming in the center of this week could be the energy you're feeling now. You've got the Queen of Pentacles. Handling business and money really well at this time, bringing in your own abundance. I think some of you could be self-employed. This is going to be a very prosperous time right now. I do think that some of you may be concerned about the welfare of those around you, family members, friends, chosen family, those around you. You may be taking care and nurturing other people as well. You have this ability to be the ultimate mother or carry that energy around you, or perhaps there's a woman around you that is guiding you and capable of giving you counsel here. Nonetheless, what you nurture will come to fruition and grow. We call her Mother Earth. She has a green thumb. She plants her seeds and she patiently waits for her harvest to come in. So, doing the work. You've already done something here with the Seven of Pentacles, and now you have the Queen of Pentacles, so definitely you're about to see things change for the better. Okay, family room. This is a new one to me. I haven't had this card come out in this deck before. So this is all about finding your space and your place of peace. They talk about that. They talk about, being able to move forward and feel at peace here. Your personal space, like your home, your apartment, anything like that. It represents, privacy and intimacy in your space. It's time to take you there. Maybe you need to retreat. Maybe you need to take this time out, as I said, and start doing things, changing things up for you. So I do think, you've planted your seeds, you've done everything you can, you're waiting for your harvest to come in, and now put your feet up and relax. Okay, coming in next, Libra, you've got the Three of Pentacles. Again, this is collaboration. I think you're pretty focused on teamwork here this week, where you're collaborating with other people, other ideas, standing up and taking a position of teaching, promoting, guiding, counseling, and conveying information to other people. People that may work for you or with you. Definitely you're learning something new here, and you're going to continue this growth because of your hard work and your commitment. You're building on, you're building on success right now. But it's all because of teamwork. Teamwork is dream work, right? So stay in that zone. I think that you're going to get recognized and rewarded for what you do. Some of you may be thinking of taking up a new credit, or maybe you're a tradesperson, and you're being able to work and show your trade and your profession and your career off to other people. So this is all about teamwork and continuing that way. Now, you're able now to set your compass, because this is coming in, the compass is coming in as well. And this is about, a journey to be taken and a choice to be made right now. So you could be making decisions and choices that are determined around your business or your job. Know that you're being guided on your path. Because we know with a compass, we're able to set, and set it true north, as we always say, that the compass comes up because you're now seeing a clear sight line. You're now knowing where you want to go. You've worked for this endeavor, and now you're going to see that this goal is going to come to fruition. So now you're able to go where you want. Now, some of you could be planning a trip of some sort, whether it's for pleasure or business, and going the distance there. Now, next, you've got the Ace of Wands, and the Ace of Wands is taking action and moving towards your goals again. It's a new beginning. We talked about an absolutely new beginning here as well, and a new start coming in. So, you know, this is good news. When we get the Ace of Wands, it's good news about something coming in. Maybe you're finding a new passion, or you're going to be offered something here and an opportunity to take action and go after your dreams. This is definitely a good card that says you're growing, you're traveling, it's exciting, you're getting in the game, and you're going after what you want. Opportunities and feeling inspired about new beginnings coming towards you. I had said maybe you were taking a trip, and look what shows up here. The card of the Voyage. And so you could be planning a trip here. You know, get ready, because maybe you're going to embark on a journey, and it might be an inner journey or an outer journey. In other words, are you traveling distance on land, or are you doing it mentally? It might be a project or an idea that's coming into life, but most certainly you are an intrepid traveler. So stay on that path. Where do you want to go? What have you always wanted to do or be? This is the time to make it happen. Libra, get prepared. Have a clear vision of what and what you want to experience here. But you also have to be prepared for the unexpected, right? And that is the part of the fun when we are traveling somewhere, where we are planning our moves to do something. And remember, enjoy the journey. It's not so much about reaching the destination, right? Well, my beautiful, beautiful Libras, this is your reading for this week. I mean, you started off with the Ten of Cups, happy ever after. You've got teamwork working with you. You're definitely having a new beginning here. You're making changes, and you're cleaning up business here, getting things organized around you in your life. So, on that note, I wish you a great remainder to today and a beautiful, optimistic week to look forward to. And always know, Libra, I send you lots of love and many blessings, and I'll see you soon.